was called up to speak a few words, and hopefully I can say enough to fill a five-minute time slot. So I'd like to give a lot of thanks. Thanks to Division II Athletics for being able to let me be a student and compete at a very high level. Also the GMAC for organizing a great conference and staying on top of things. This has been great. They've got me here, and everything's gone smoothly, and they've been doing a really good job. Also Cedarville Athletics, I think of just everybody in the athletic department who has done an awesome job, and especially even the maintenance people that mow our cross-country field. That's where I like to always run. So I'm very appreciative of what they do there as well. Very thankful for my coach, Coach Orchard. He's done more than you would probably know. As an engineer, I graduated, that was my undergrad engineering, so I had a lot of later classes, and he would stay back if it was a workout and help me out if I had to do a workout. And that just meant so much to me because he sacrificed some time from away from his family. And just to get me, you know, excited about running, keep me excited about running. I'd like to also thank my teammates who are not here, but they've been a really encouraging group of men that have really built each other up, and I'm thankful for Cedarville, who creates that atmosphere where we have that. So I have to talk a little bit about where I've been and where I'm heading. So going into my fifth year, I was planning on not having a fifth year, but I got hurt. So I was able to come back for a fifth year, which I'm very thankful for. And I had planned a cross-the-country bike trip from Washington to Long Island. And, you know, so I wasn't, when I planned the bike trip, I wasn't planning on running another year. But it actually ended up being really good. I was able to ride my bike across the country for Safe Harbor House, which is a local ministry here in Cedarville. And that kept me in shape for running, so I came back ready to run for the fall 2015 cross-country season. Ended up having a really good season, despite maybe my lack of running, even though I did ride my bike a lot. But one highlight from that season was just, I guess, winning the Midwest Regional meet. And I remember my coach crying with tears of joy, because last year it was tears of sorrow, because that was the race that I was planning on, you know, doing really well at, and unfortunately I got hurt. So the very next year, it made it all worth it coming back for a fifth year, knowing that I could help my team, lead my team with a win. Unfortunately, we didn't qualify as a team, but it was just really exciting to have my whole team excited for me as well. And then into the spring, ended up getting hurt again, so I wasn't able to run indoor track, which is my last season of eligibility. But it's been really good to be at Cedarville for 5 years, finishing up my master in ministry. I've been so blessed to have people like my coach and my teammates to support me through all of these credits of master's degrees, and it was a tough time for me, knowing that I couldn't run, but at the same time I was able to really build into these young men that were looked up to me. I took that platform and I ran with it, and led a Bible study with them, and it was just a really encouraging time for them. Hopefully, it was definitely an encouraging time for me as well. So for the future, still running, and I can see myself going into triathlon. I've been being pushed forwards with some people that are really big into triathlon, so we'll see what that has to offer, but for right now, I'm just going to stick with running. But I enjoy running, and I don't think I'll ever give it up, so thank you very much.
Benjamin, thank you for the resilience.